It's July and it's getting hot, just like the deals at Appalachian Wireless. All month, get the Samsung Galaxy S8 for just a penny with a two-year agreement. But don't wait, because the deal ends soon. Better service, bigger savings. That's today's Appalachian Wireless.
There's no question US 23 is one of the most traveled roads in eastern Kentucky, and a survey going on right now is letting our first responders know exactly what hazardous materials are traveling through Pike County.
It's a liquid suspension of ammonium nitrate in that tanker that just went by.
In the past few weeks, motorists traveling US 23 through Pikeville may have noticed vehicles and a tent at the Buckley's Creek intersection. That's the location of a survey being conducted in conjunction with Pike County Emergency Management.
They're actually graduate students from Western Kentucky University doing a project, a commodity flow survey. They're recording all the trucks that carry placards, which tell them that there's a hazardous material in that truck.
Pike County Emergency Management Director Doug Tackett says recording the different hazardous materials traveling through Pike County will give his office some much-needed information.
If we know what's traveling through our area on our roads and railroad, let's not forget it, we can better prepare our responders and our hazmat team to deal with some of those chemicals should there be a spill.
And just looking up some of the materials that went by while we were there was an eye-opening experience.
Highly flammable, easily ignited by heat, sparks, or flames. I mean, just an exhaust pipe, a hot exhaust could spark it off. It gives us evacuation distances, gives us protective clothing that needs to be worn, and just a host of information.
Tackett says he is thankful that funding was made available for the survey, which will be a game changer in the event of a chemical spill.
We got a federal grant to do this commodity flow survey. This is being done with our local emergency planning committee, and we finally had the funds to do a match on the grant to do this survey, something we've been needing to do for a while.
Results of the survey will be presented to Pike County officials at the end of August. In Pikeville, I'm Shannon Deskins, EKB News.